Angelo Duminică is my name. Now I work for Umbrella Agency for Community Development, a foundation based in Romania working with Roma minority. First of all, I'm Roma, you know, and my family was victim of the Holocaust, you know, because they were deported during the Second War. But this was not the main reason. You know, even that I was raised in this kind of issues, you know, the main reason was the possibility that was offered to me during my university time, during my studies, to have a voluntary internship in a foundation based in Romania. And on that moment, I chose to come in this foundation as volunteer. I discovered the world of Roma movement and become like a virus. I tried to skip this virus from 15 years and I'm not succeeding. A lot of things, you know, I'm not the person who said that nothing is changing. No? A lot of things happen and I saw a lot of developments in a lot of communities. But in the same time, you know, I saw a lot of discrimination, self-discriminations, you know, and a lot of lack of the political will from the governments. I saw a lot of double standards that are used. I saw a lot of different discourses that are offered by different European countries, you know, related to the human rights. So all the other peoples have a right, the Roma, it's different, you know, like, for example, you know, free circulation inside the European Union, etc., etc. But I'm quite optimistic regarding the perspective, you know, that the Roma development will have, you know, and because otherwise I will become crazy. Împreună in English means together. We are really believe in this. It's not an issue that it's in our name. It's a credo that we have, and this I saw in the last year, in the last 15 years. This kind of togetherness, you know, become a reality in many communities. A lot of Roma, you know, are very well included in society. A lot of Roma, you know, are very well educated. They promote, I don't know what things for the European and economy. But nobody perceived them as Roma, you know, because in the public mentality, being Roma means to be migrant, a beggar, thief, and all these kind of issues. What we succeed in the last years is to bring together hundreds, thousands of Roma students, Roma very doctors, lawyers, artists, etc., that create a common front. And that create a common vision that, you know, together we can succeed. You know, the concept name, it's what you want to be when you grow up. It's a question that everybody received when they were a child. But for our children, many of the visible Roma, the answer, it's so simple. They can become beggars, or that they can become victim of the trafficking. Because nobody told them that they can become doctors. You know, now we offer them the possibility to choose because we bring inside of these communities Roma that are doctors, telling them, yes, you can. Because as liberal can sound, we cannot develop a nation with the poorest one. You know, we need to have our middle class. You know, because the middle class, you know, will become the internal engine necessary for the entire Roma movement. So this is what we are doing. I think the best step that we made in the last years is bringing the public, bringing in the media eyes, this kind of invisible Roma middle class. In my mind, you know, investing in Roma is not necessarily a human rights issue. It's more It's a smart economical argument. In 2050, Romania will have 16 million inhabitants. According to the Eurostat, 1.5, 1.6 will be represented by Roma. So this means 10% comparing with 7 now. So the age of the population on that moment will be something like, so the middle age will be something like 53 years old. You know, so somebody that will have 53 will be in the middle of population, comparing with 34 in this moment. So aging will be a huge problem. Even that the Roma will represent, you know, 10%, the proportion of the Roma minority inside of the active labor population, you know, people that are able to work will be something like 40%. So 40% of the entire labor force existing in Romania will be represented by Roma. So in this moment, having in mind all this, we need to decide what to do with the Roma that are currently living in Romania. To treat them as a scapegoat and to continue with the same status quo like now. No investment or very poor investment with poor results. Or to consider them as a resource that Romania have and to invest a lot in them because they will represent the future labor force that Romania need in 20 years from now. So if we invest in Roma in this moment, somebody will be able to pay our pension in 30 years period from now. Somebody will be able to pay the necessary taxes for the hospital, for the kindergarten system, for everything you want. If we are not investing, Romania will collapse because they cannot afford a very aged population and a low proportion of dependent persons, non-active person on the labor market. So investing in Roma, saying that, you know, investing in Roma is not necessarily a human right. Investing in what we call in this moment disadvantaged persons is not necessarily a human rights, you know, issue. It's more an economical argument. Doesn't matter from which wing the politicians come. They still consider that Roma are, you know, the worst part of the population. Now, till recently, you know, the definition in the Romanian dictionary for the word Tsigan, Roma, was something like adjective offered to a person with bad behavior. So this means, when you look at me, you will see a person with bad behavior. We fight with the Romanian Academy for 7 years in order to change the definition. After 7 years, we succeed. Because our aim was not only to change the definition. Our aim was to win respect for a minority that exists in this country for more than 700 years. But the Roma were slaves in this country for 600 years. No, sell like animals, you know, so they were the property of the whites, call it whites, you know, the Romanians. And it's very hard to change this kind of thinking in 100 years without no measures, no active measures promoted by the government. And this government still consider, in many issues, the Roma being the new slaves, you know, something that can be sold very easy. For that, a lot of Roma are in the Western countries. Because nobody cares about the Roma as Romanian citizens. So it doesn't matter the government, political color. The treatment is the same. The Roma are not Romanians. I don't have dreams. I have only, beliefs. You know, and my belief is that my child, when I have it, we live in a more normal world comparing with now. And I want to have an answer. And when he will ask me, or she will ask me, I hope to be a he, and what you do in order to change, you know? And on that moment, I want to be able to look on his eyes and to tell him this I succeed to do. Be smarter than me and do more.